Oh. Excuse me. Is this the singing bush?
Yeah!
Last week on Stealth Diggers, our friends Debbie, Doug, David, and Travis drove all the way from Millington, Illinois to spend 5 days in New Hampshire with us.
Charlie, how you doing, man?
Hey, how are you?
This is the 10-minute clad challenge.
Doug comes in first place, 12 cents.
Oh, hello.
Whoa!
It looked like an egg.
I extracted it perfectly.
Weedy excitement.
I'm hungry for dead animal.
Some people call it burning it.
Oh, no!
Boy's not right.
All right, listen up!
So, the plan is early night at the shack, getting up early, and tomorrow, Canoodle shall be returning.
Yeah! Awesome.
And we're going to see the Curbinator.
Woo! Yeah!
See you in the morning. Say goodnight, everyone.
Good morning.
Be back in 4 seconds. Hey, remember last night when we said see you in 4 seconds?
Yeah.
This is it. Boom. You gotta love the convenience of editing. Here we go. What day is it?
Tuesday.
It is?
It's day three.
I said Tuesday also.
Hitting the road.
All right, today is a very special day. We're going home.
Oh no.
Ow. Did some research, found this abandoned hippie site. We're gonna hit that, but that's just a sidetrack. What we're gonna be doing is we're gonna go down a hill, then up a hill, following this old road, then down another hill, taking a corner, and there's several sites out there.
When did you put a basement in here?
Well, it's a long story.
All right, I'm gonna go work on the crystals.
Okay, great.
All right, everybody ready?
Yeah!
Ready! Yeah.
Here we go. This is the start of day three. Engage. That means go. Everybody run. Boom, boom, boom! Oh, hi, Tim.
What's going on, brother? Always a pleasure. Finally landed in Moose Balls.
Yeah.
Crew's here. Be a good dig.
So we've got a different approach today because we have our friends here, and this is going to be a completely different experience for them. We'll explain it as we go along. We've got to get our gear all together and get moving.
He had the vest on when we were throwing spoons at him in the corner.
Yeah. Oh, that's from last night?
Yeah, from last night.
What would you like to find tomorrow on day number three?
It's yours then.
See, my day's already starting out good.
All right, so we're still getting everybody to get their stuff together so we can move. And Noodles is over here probing in the road. What did you just find?
A wheat penny.
There you go.
You know who's laughing at you right now.
Yeah, I know.
All right, so we're starting to make our trip, and we got a snake on the other side of the wall. Throw him in the washer.
Hey, John, you get one in, I get the other, and see who finds the head.
Oh, yeah, that's a timber rattle.
What did Keebler just say? Because I don't think anybody heard him.
Oh, yeah, that's a timber rattle.
Oh.
Oh, he's trying to get you.
Yeah. That's one of these guys.
Here, I'll throw him in the washer.
John, really, it's a worm.
Snake, it's dangerous up here. You gotta watch where you step.
He's just going to Australia where he's gonna...
Yeah, dump pouch.
Boy's not right.
All right, put him back in the sun. Let him continue tanning.
You spot him, Charlie?
Yeah.
Oh, he's gonna strike you.
Oh, he don't like you.
Damn.
I've never seen any.
He is rattling.
Stand up to
something
like that.
Rattle, I told you.
You remember the white devil that jumped out? That jumped out of
Key. He don't like you.
We passed the first challenge. Why did it have to be snakes? Crossing a bridge at the moment. Well, the experience today, what we're going to do is we're going to take them for a day of finding abandoned home sites. They're going to experience it with us as we go. Keeb secured this location for us, but we're unaware of what's out here. So they're going to get first-hand experience of what it's like to scout and find a site and have first dibs at it.
So the snake that David was just messing with is what?
Northeast American timber rattler.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Well, you do realize everybody that was watching that 2 minutes ago was going, stay away from the snake.
All the comments down below.
Right.
You know what that is?
Holy cow.
Thanks for all the views.
No problem.
If you had went down, we would have hit a million.
You were mad as hell.
He didn't know.
Oh, there we go.
What's this?
Yeah.
Did you guys know I can parkour? Was it parkour?
Parkour.
Yeah, I'm going to parkour.
So you're going to jump
rock,
over.
That rock and then back again.
And do an egg roll on the way.
On the counter.
Wow.
Wow.
Hey Keith, thanks for telling me that's a rattlesnake. Look at that. You all caught that?
Yeah.
There's a hole in there.
See that spot right over there across the river? It's a hole that had been eroded by the water through the eons. So, of course, Keebler and David have to go inside and look. And I'm glad they did, because wow.
18.
Is that 18 or 16?
18, 21. And then there's something here.
Yeah.
I can't make that out too well. Kind of old. And then there's a big one down here.
Yeah. This right here. H.
Yeah.
HR.
Puffin stuff.
Oh, wow. Look at this one. Oh, there we go. 1771.
1771.
This is truly amazing.
Smile, peeps.
I'm down in a hole.
Let's leave them. No.
Yeah, I need a handout of this one.
Maybe he'll grow.
I got you.
Truly amazing.
That is.
Wow.
What'd you find?
Yep, missed
plastic
it.
Plastic spoons.
Where?
Where?
Right here.
Oh, yeah.
Surf is fine. Woohoo! First spoon of the day. Yeah. No, second spoon of the day. Yeah.
That's that translucent aluminum stuff.
One magically appeared in your pocket earlier.
All right, so we're literally climbing up and up and up. Curbinator, what would you estimate we have climbed in elevation?
800 feet.
I don't know. I'm bad at that, but it's a good grade, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, more than likely the home site's gonna be at the top of the hill. Wow, just when you think it's not gonna go up anymore,
it goes up more.
I'm pretty sure Led Zeppelin wrote about this place. It's called Stairway to Heaven.
Or
yeah,
Highway to Hell.
This is it.
This has got to be it.
Plant and Page were hanging out here with the rest of the hippies down at the falls.
If I say to you tomorrow.
Exactly. All of you that are indigenous to Saskatchewan, let's see if they can spot the signs. This is your challenge. Like last night with the flute, find the hole.
Spot the hole. First one to spot the hole gets to turn on the detector first.
You got a 60-second head start.
I found it.
All right, Debbie. You literally get the 60-second head start. And it's really old. There's no cut granite in it. It's all stone. And I already decided last night I'm not going to come in here and give this thing a proper lashing. I'm going to let you guys have at it. And then when you're all comfortable about having your time with it, I'll come in and tickle it.
That's gracious of you to take seconds.
I want you guys to have the best experience possible, and I want you to find great things.
Just so you know, you guys already have given us the best experience by letting us come here and join you.
It's a full service experience here in Saskatchewan.
They even checked the undercarriage.
All right, here we go. We got a culture.
Cutlery.
Knife blades. Very nice.
Yeah, there's something else in here that's really small.
That's a good artifact, man.
Yeah.
Nice, good job.
Thank you.
Holy mackerel. Here's the well, guys. And be very careful with the well. There's actually a banana peel on top of it. Very slippery.
Was it the stealth banana?
Nobody suspects the stealth banana.
Oh my God. It could be.
So here's another kind of neat bug in the mouth, right to the tonsils. That's the threshold stone. It was up in the front there. You know that's where I'm heading afterwards. Because that thing slid down and they could have put a coin under it. It could have dragged stuff in with it. More than likely there's an oxen shoe under it. Travis is on the backside. That's a nice lip over there.
Yeah, a lot of iron sounds.
Yeah, definitely tickle that thing.
I'm a tickler.
I thought it was some sort of button. I thought that was a shank pushed down in there.
That is. Is it a crushed zoob?
It's a ball button. Crushed.
That's the top. That's the shank side. You can actually see the so shank. So I'm not tripping. There
somebody,
is one in
somebody
there.
Somebody broke your ball.
No.
Hey, man, yeah. Stop busting my ball. Here we go. My culture. Out behind the holes over there, there's a little stone wall. Then there's another little corral out here. Paddock, whatever you want to call it. About 6 inches down. I got myself an arm buckle. Well, only been here like 5 minutes, so we're going to keep going.
Everyone was given their head start. They tickled the lip for a bit. Got to take a listen of what it's all about. They've moved out into the front yard and stuff. Ninjen, as you're going to see coming up in the continuum, she's staying at the lip. That's what she wants to do. She's hell-bent on learning how to pick stuff out of the iron because that's the thing. It's the challenge that's awesome. You can pull something itty-bitty like a button out of a bed of nails. It's very rewarding. Good job, Ninjen. Dedication.
Props.
Giving you props. I'm letting them know so that as they can see in the continuum coming up that this is your mission. That's what you want to be good at. You want to be a rim tickler.
Yes, I do.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
You found another bottle? I was looking for the signs. Apparently this guy drank too much and lost his button. Would you say that's a tombac? Coming in solid 76 to 78.
And it's brass.
And it's brass, and it was down that far.
Awesome, man. You got the button bug.
Yeah.
Nice.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yep, little piece of cloth on it.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, look at that, huh? Amazing. That is actually cloth.
Stayed on all those years.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Noodles is chasing a 52 signal on the oh wow meter.
Oh, wait a minute, what is that? Piece of this.
Oh, put it through the washer, clean it.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, that's part of shoe buckle frame.
Is it?
Very nice, yes it is. Yep, okay, so see.
Oh, right,
that's
yep.
Where the pin went. Nice, good job, man. You pulled like 3 nails out before that, so.
I know, I'm like, there has to be that 52. I'm not hearing stuff that much.
No, you knew you were chasing something.
That is awesome.
Yeah.
Two knives, and a button.
Very knife. What you got?
Got me a button.
Oh, nice. I love this design. That's the convex with the nipple in the middle.
Ooh, nipple-ish.
Yeah, that's late 1700s right there. We don't pop too many of those up around here.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yay!
Nice job, Jennifer.
Thank you.
Dug, this.
Dug.
Dig, dug.
Dig, dug.
Did Doug dig this?
Yes, Doug did dig that.
Did you see Doug dig this?
I didn't see Doug dig nothing.
I'm doubting I did see Doug dig this.
No, because Doug doesn't know what Doug dug. Dig, dug doesn't know what dig, dug, dug. So what did dig, dug, dug? Dig.
Done digs.
Wow.
High
did I
five.
Spit that out? Wow.
Hey, I was that impressed.
Props. Nice.
Hey, is that the first time you had that many D's in your mouth?
D's what? D's nuts.
D's dugs.
D's dugs.
I'm in the cave-in, front side of the hole. That signal was awfully scratchy, but check it out.
It got something on it? It's got some gilt. Yeah, that's probably why the numbers were so crazy.
Whoa.
Hold the press.
I think I got something different. Differentness. Tell me what you see on that. It's a can. Whoa, dude. Carbonator. You got the scopes on.
USA. Yeah, it has USA and... I can't see without a light, but it says USA on the bottom. Yeah.
Regiment?
First Regiment.
I just got chills all over my body.
Yeah, it's a cannon. It's an artillery.
Yeah.
It's a First Regiment artillery button.
Yay.
Oh. I am getting chills all up and down
my spine.
As
soon as I saw that USA, I'm like, here we go.
See that, John? You can see it.
Holy crap. Back that light off of here. Wow.
That is barking awesome.
First regiment with a cannon, and then USA, something at the bottom, but it'll clean up.
Holy sheep.
So, as I was saying, I'm working the cave-in where I was pointing out earlier where the threshold stone is, and I was talking about stuff falling down in.
Telling you,
hit the sidewalls, the cave-ins, but hey, forget about it. I'm out of here anyways. So, they're doing a Punky Brewster marathon today, and I want to catch it.
So later in the day, Curbinator sends me a message, says, take a second look at that button. Do you know how extremely rare that is? That button is extremely, extremely rare. Only produced 1799 to 1802. Not that we ever put a dollar price on anything we dig, but when looking this button up online, there were two examples. That's all I could find. One was listed for $2,500. The other one that was listed had sold for $2,500. Not that I'm looking at it as to what it's worth, but that shows the extreme rarity of that button. And man, what a find. That's probably the rarest thing I have ever found.
Seriously, I will get out of here immediately. I want you guys to come over here and hit this cave in, okay?
Yeah, me and you, we'll get right in here.
Have at it.
Probably skull go on the back.
Oh, wow, you literally didn't move.
I'm guessing a button.
I think you got a button, man.
Yes, you do, with shankage.
Awesome.
Awesome one piece.
With shank.
With shank. There you go. Your first official New England relic.
Awesome.
Hey, Debbie.
All right. Well, Curbinator has to be disembarking. What'd you find?
Well, Shotgun Wayne has been throughout this place.
Son of.
Yeah, a bunch of shells. A little CCR, I think.
Ah. Oh, nice. Nice. Well, you completed part of the challenge.
I found new friendships. That's what I found.
That's all that matters.
Hey.
So I'll let you say goodbye to everybody.
The only thing that's not making this an orgy is you're all dressed.
Not from the waist down, though.
Yeah, right.
Hey, be careful of snakes on the way back. That's all I got to say.
So we're going to say au revoir to the Curbinator, and we're gonna move on down the road and see what else is down there in the sake of...
Stay up here. See ya.
Live from day 17.
Nice meeting you.
All right. We be moving on down the road.
Let's see your bean pot.
Pretty cool, actually. I think.
That sounds good.
Any treasure's good treasure.
Nice.
Yeah.
You must have left the lid on too long and exploded.
Exactly.
Well, like we always say, yeah,
it's a broken piece of something, but it's still part of
history.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Something that's
awesome.
It's old.
I can honestly say I don't have one. Now I do.
Yeah, and it came from.
It came from New England.
Best, yes. That's the beginning.
And guess what? I'll keep it forever.
Awesome.
All right. Well. What we did was we went down the road, Keebler took the gang, further down found a site. Myself, Ninjen, Doug, we're going to hang at the hole that the military button came out of till they come back. So if he has footage, we'll watch that right now.
We're at this little hole, and believe me, it's tiny, very small footprint. It's right in the middle of a square. I'm sorry, a triangle. And we hear this.
You coming in or I'm coming out?
Oh, no, I'm coming in to you. What's all the brouhaha? Oh.
Well, let's just say I got a fork to eat my dinner later. Wow. And look at the detail that's left in the scales.
That is incredible. You know how old this is, right?
I'm going to say late 1700s.
Yeah. Wow. Look at that. Unheard of.
Look how it's still kind of white on that side.
Yeah, bone.
Bone?
Bone.
Get out of here.
Yep. And it's been sleeping there for probably...
2 inches.
200 years.
200 years.
Yeah. And what, you got piece off an old sewing machine.
Yeah, I'll go with the old part. I like that.
Yeah.
God,
and we're going to go take a look and see what Noodles just found.
So this is what I got around the lip of the hole.
Sketch and hold it the right way. So that
right here... is where the bolt would come through and there was a ring or something or a knob and you'd be pulling that drawer out.
It's fancy.
Fancy, yeah.
And
is that lead?
I think so.
Wow, lead spoon to go with that colonial fork that was just found.
Yep.
Any fancy?
It says C. Parker on it.
Why would I want to see him?
Oh, he probably died from eating the lead spoon.
Yeah. Anyways, Charlie just messaged me. Let me get to that, and we'll find out what we're doing here.
Yeah, yard, garden. A lot of times, this would be like their flower garden close to the house.
As you know, we let people do extractions.
It's actually out of the hole, and I'll let you be the first person to touch it in, you know, a couple hundred years.
This must be it.
Oh, that looks like a big one.
Yes, it is.
Very nice. Breaking up, but hey.
Still an artifact, and it's awesome.
Yeah.
And oddly enough, what were we talking about coming back up the road?
Oh,
thimbles.
Thimbles, yes.
And it did. It rang up. Actually, that one rang up close to 50, so it was a bit higher than normal.
Okay, that is awesome.
That was worth coming back for.
So you say you found a what?
It's kind of buckle. It's like 6 inches down.
It's old horse tack. Old, not colonial, but old.
Okay. Cool.
All right, nice.
You want to see what I found?
What'd you find?
Jen, what does this sound like?
Awesome.
K-son.
Yeah?
Tell me what this sounds like to you.
A horn or a butt.
What does it sound like to you?
Well, that's a sea shark.
I just have to check. It is.
You got an old pocket knife.
Yep, part of it.
Oh, yeah.
I got this part out first. I thought it might have been something, but then I said no.
Yeah.
Hey, it's something different.
It is.
I like it.
Is there a year on it?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, let's take a look.
Oh, no, it's a stinking Lincoln.
Look it over.
It's a stinking Lincoln.
Memorial. You got a what kind of casing?
3220 Peters.
Are you singing?
Whoa, a repeater rifle. Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I've always heard of the 3220. I've never seen one.
Wow.
Shine up to Peters.
Yeah. All right, this is number what?
This is number 8.
8.
Total in the 2 days, but.
He brought 9 with him.
Yeah. I got one more to find.
Nice. And, oh, half shank.
Half shank.
We got a new name?
Half shank. It's about time I had to give up half a shank.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right, so you guys are back.
Yeah, it was really nice all around. Finds, some really incredible stuff we'll show you.
Yeah, we watched your footage while we were here, recapping in the same day.
Whoa.
So I'm gonna show you something that I found.
It's kind of a, you know, biggie thing. It's a first.
Oh boy!
Oh my God!
It's not Spanish silver.
Oh my God!
All right, so what I was doing was...
What was you doing was?
Rim tickling.
I was rim tickling.
Yeah, the only way I can capture the signal in here is vertically. I can't swing because I'm in the tree and... Let's get you guys in closer. Oh! You gotta see this.
Oh.
You kidding me?
Gotta go into I'm telling you, that cave-in is like...
Right along the tree there.
Look at the size of that thing!
Oh, that's a beauty! Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow! Fantastic!
I love to see you smile.
That gives me chills. Wow! And again, let me show you. Well, you can see we're in the hole. Doug's really in the hole, right? And that thing was not shallow by any means.
It's got fancy on it, look.
Oh, it does.
It does, it so does. Gorgeous. Good job.
Thanks.
All right, back to swinging. Hold the show, check your hole.
It's in the brass range. All right, let's do this, ready? Team effort. Come on down. Discover what's in there.
No!
Oh, it is!
Way.
Yes!
Oh,
holy crap!
You're kidding!
Oh my God!
Nothing screams colonial more than that.
Oh!
No!
Get out of here!
That's freaking awesome!
Get out of here,
awesome
y'all!
Job,
A
Charlie.
Complete
Blink symbol.
Oh my god!
You have got to be kidding me.
Blink oh symbol. My god!
Oh, sweet!
Right?
Yep, now it'd be complete.
That is the largest complete shoe buckle I have ever found.
Can you just imagine someone walking around with that like that?
That is
beautiful. Oh man.
Always
nice.
Catch your hole. Wow. Damn, you're good.
Wow.
May I?
Yes, may.
Handle this a little bit.
That's incredible.
Oh my god!
I just have to point out something about this shoe buckle that makes it even a more remarkable and personalized type of find. Look at that. The person who was wearing this made the attempt at fixing it with some baling wire, and that's why it was in two pieces. But look at the iron wire, stayed intact. It adds more to the mental stimulation of the wonder of it all.
All right, I'm coming up out of the hole here.
I was distracted by, you know.
What was the word you said? Bogarting?
Oh, he wanted to hold it, and I was bogarting the buckle.
So you were the buckle bogarter.
Yes. So and then I came back to my hole, and I found shankage
nice.
A little broke, but it's still a beauty.
Well, there's fancy on it, Jen.
Is there? Oh, there is fancy. Oh, wow, there's a lot of fancy on that.
Yeah, that's different, huh?
Sweet.
Awesome, see?
And I got fancies on it.
Well, I'm going to hit the other side and go down and possibly find a hole that we had missed.
All right, if you do, let us know. I'm going to give this thing a proper lashing,
yeah.
And hopefully I can get the gang to tickle the hole. And imagine if we left and didn't come back.
Yeah. All right.
Part of a spoon bowl, part of a spoon handle.
It's the middle of the spoon.
The middle of the spoon.
And it's pewter. Very nice.
It's pewter, Rebuta.
Yeah, repute of the Buddha.
Yeah.
That's good, because day three needed a spoon toss or two.
Good. Nice.
All right, let's get back to it.
Action.
Oh, my God.
All right, I'm going over to see David, because he's got a signal.
Oh, my God. I got coinage.
No, you don't.
I got coinage.
Get out of here. You got bingo?
I got bingo, baby.
Yes. Oh, you do.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Facing this way.
Is that George 2 or 3?
3. Is that right there?
Yeah. Facing.
Oh, man! Woo-hoo!
Yep, King George the 3rd.
Yeah. Oh, I
lost! Noodles!
Nice job.
Let's see it, buddy.
Dude,
come on up.
Hey, I'll kick it in Darren Jen's face.
Come on!
He's gonna pass out.
I'm getting in your way, Charlie.
Oh! She got a King George the 3rd.
Next to Jen.
Imagine that. We left this spot earlier. Dumb some bitches.
Woo!
And you know what? Here is something else. She's in the chimney stack. That's bizarre, but.
Is it bean pot?
Chimney smalls. Just a piece of metal. What do we have here?
I think you got another button.
Another button.
Oh, you got a match, don't you?
Yes, I do. Shank and all. Yes, sirree.
Wow. Good job, man. That little thing was loud.
No, that's why you double check your holes.
I dug
out that piece of junk.
All right, so we got Mr. Canoodles over here.
What you got? A tombat. What the heck did I do with it now?
Yeah, well, I had a tombat. No. Oh, my God. Really?
Don't worry. 6,000 people will wait for you.
Perfect.
Oh, beautiful, man. Very nice. Yeah.
All right, I'm way out on an orbit. I found the first cross wall back out that way, probably a quarter mile, and that's where the hole is where everybody's been finding the fabulous things today. So I'm out here just out and about. I see this clearing out here. That was busted through right over there. And right over there, that's a huge pile of rock. And I come out to this clearing, and looky here. Somebody built a fireplace. I don't know, 50, 60 years ago maybe, who knows. So I swung out here and I dug here and there and I found bottle caps and stuff like that. But this one rang up beautiful. Oh, look at that. This better not be clad. 19, 1957.
All right. Silva, 1951. Rosie. Gosh, these skis are terrible.
It must be the theme for the week.
No way. Oh, man. Yeah, park. I started a trend of the week.
Love these things. I just moved not even a foot over, and there's the handle with scales to the fork. Awesome. So it's complete. It's just in two pieces.
I don't know. It's a little ring. I don't know exactly. Then right over here from there, I got a nice old flat button with shank, half shank. All right, that's what I got. So first, it just never fails. Every time you say you're gonna leave, you hit a find. I was just on the other side of this rock pile and I was walking over the top and of course, got a really nice signal. I thought it was a coin, but no, it's a I believe a tomback by the looks of the back. Maybe not. It's not wiping clean as it should. It's probably the same error as the other button I found on the other side. It's a UFO. Holy, oh my.
All right, so Travis was out on the triangle, the intersection.
Right where I would have sat down. If...
Oh, yeah. You can see the gold gilt.
Yeah.
Don't think I see any design.
No, but
still.
You got shankage and you get some gilt on the back, so.
That's awesome.
That's all I wanted is one button. I'm happy.
You got it.
All right, so coming down here to the traffic triangle with Travis
over there, found his button. Doug. Doug. Oh, you did dig a button in the road.
I believe underneath
the shank
dirt.
Is in there. Wow, very cool, man.
Three for the day.
Yeah.
Gotta keep going. That's awesome.
Well, that out there had to have been something, you know, the more I think about it, maybe like a Boy Scout camp or something. But this rock pile, I'll tell you, definitely old, very old. Just pulled this out. Oh, wait, I thought it was a button. This sucker's a coin. Coin! And tell you what. It was down there, under that root. Let me dry this out some, and we shall see what it is. All right there, facing to the left. Take it out, I can see the lady. Lady on the back. Is that it right there? Can you see it now? It's just too hard to show it on camera.
This is how it works around here. Rim Tickler and the Orbiter. That's the name of the band.
Yeah!
I like it.
Me too.
We're getting the band back together!
Or Orbiter and the Rim Ticklers. Wow, that was something out there. We saw the clips while we were still here. So actually, tell me about your approach when you went out there, because the hole is right there, keeps okay. Left for orbit.
It's like this. I would take a step, yep. And I would swing.
Okay.
And I would take a step. No, I went down to the next crosswall, walked it in, the average cross contamination. I've come across this really nice flat area. Somebody had built a fireplace, a lot of activities, a lot of finds.
You know it's time to go home and eat when stealth cam is heavy.
So heavy.
Yeah.
Where's Canoodles?
He went looking for keeps to get water.
Oh, man.
All right, so just realize that Canoodles is gone. We're gonna head back to Kit. Hopefully we find him, head back to the shack, eat, and do other things.
Well, we found Canoodles.
What are you doing down here, boy?
Well, I planted a water halfway down here. I'm up there like, oh, I'm gonna die.
That hill was something, huh?
Oh my God, I can't believe we walked up that.
That's what I'm saying. It didn't seem it going up.
No. Nope.
Makes no sense.
I'm walking down, I'm like, I'm not going up this again. So I was gonna come back up, but nope.
What happened with the liquid situation?
I left the water halfway, like I always do.
Right.
You know? No mistake. I'm a snake in
well,
it.
Well, that's what happens when you put all your eggs in one basket.
But for now, for now, it's all water under the fridge.
Right. Survival of the fitness.
Oh, put all your eggs in one basket.
Dave, you see what happens when you put all your eggs in one basket?
What?
What a great day. It all started, I mean everything, from the finds, just the way it started when our friend picked up a rattlesnake.
Timber rattler. Not a rattler, well, it's timber rattler.
It's a snake and it rattled.
And it wanted to bite hard.
It did. So we're heading back to the shack.
Jack.
It would have been a big mistake if he got bit.
It would have been a huge mistake.
Don't move.
All right, so we had an awesome meal. We're all tired. Day three was woo-hoo!
fantastic. So to save the video time and save you time, and they've never experienced this before, time thrust.
All right.
On to tomorrow morning. No 4-second delay like yesterday.
Nope.
Instantaneous.
Don't put all your eggs in one basket.
Instantaneous.
Let me push it. It was a big mistake.
Do I need to hold on?
Don't hit the wrong button.
No, it's smooth ride.
Not that one. Whenever you're ready, Keebs.
I'm feeling fine. Let's do tomorrow.
Happy birthday, dear Ginger Bear.
Hey, where's Canoodles?
Happy birthday to you.
Well, here we are, day 4, and it's David's birthday in Saskatchewan. Happy birthday, buddy.
Thank you.
Nice.
Birthday, nice sunny boy. Catch.
I'm kind of nervous. You're sitting where Canoodles was, so there may have been a mashup in DNA when we thrusted.
Is he under you?
He might be in you.
Oh, okay, I won't check.
Oh my, there he is.
I think I got a tick. Yeah. I got a tick on you guys.
So we're celebrating David's birthday today.
We lost Canoodles.
This is day 4. Day 4 is our casual fun day here in Saskatchewan.
Oh.
Hey, this wasn't here when we left yesterday.
Oh. Donnie must have came by while we were in the continuum.
You know what that means? We're going to have to open this very shortly. Hey, you know what's weird about this? It smells like chicken. Smell that.
Smells like tannerite.
Smell my box.
Ooh. That smells like chicken.
Oh, I hate chicken. Get that crap away from me. What the hell?
Right?
Oh, so it's David's birthday, right? So... look at that.
Oh,
look at that. It's even got your name on it.
Oh, wow.
That is fancy. No,
and one more thing. See, the cool thing about David is he collects vintage toys, don't you?
Yes, I do.
So I've got something that you don't actually have in your collection.
Really now?
Yeah. Close your eyes, and I'll kiss you.
Tomorrow I'll miss you.
That's right. But remember.
No tongue action.
Oh, no, this is.
I'm gonna stick the tongue out again. Close your eyes.
All right, open your eyes. It's yours.
Get out of here.
That's yours, man.
Are you? No.
Yeah. What is that, David?
That is the Masters of the Universe lampshade. A lamp I have never seen before.
Yeah, baby.
That is cool.
It goes to the one person who can appreciate it more than anyone else I can think of.
I'm going to cry.
Happy birthday.
I know, right?
Thank you very much.
Perfect. Hey, man. I'm stuck again.
Oh, man.
Really?
Yep.
Twist it to the left.
I'm trying.
Keep getting stuck in the continuum. Oh.
Ring, ring. Mail call.
Oh. Donnie Bailey.
The Space-Time Continuum Express Company.
I think he's Santa Claus.
Well, since you've opened your gifts, and we got a gift sent to the shack from Mr. Al Manuel, to Digga Charlie and all the Stealth Digga group. That includes you guys, so. Yes. All right, well, here's the letter from Al. I won this prize from a raffle in my metal detecting club, Southern Middle Tennessee Coin and Relic Hunters. Apparently, Al is the club's secretary.
Oh,
Secretary
fancy.
Al, can you come in here, please?
Right, this item simply does not fit the decor of my home, nor do I think it fits anyone's decor.
Oh, no.
Please send this to the great beyond. I can't wait until one day I can visit the shack and meet all the wonderful members of Stealth Diggers. Keep making those great videos. Live free or die. Big Al Manuel.
So he wants it sent into the abyss?
The abyss or the cornfields.
Oh, wow.
I wonder why. Nice box, Al.
Hey, nice box.
Oh my god, get the thing out of here. Oh my god. Hey. Oh god. Wow.
Looks like something Grandma would have on her daughter.
It's not real.
You gotta get rid of that thing. You gotta blow that up.
What are you gonna do with that little mother clocker?
That's so.
He wants it sent to the great beyond. What do you think?
I think that seeing that we have a guest here, we're gonna let them take care of it.
Oh, let's go chicken.
Al, it's on. All right, so David just had a brilliant idea. Tell them what you're gonna do.
I'm gonna take what's left of this real chicken and I'm gonna stuff the fake one.
Get in there.
Yeah, and stuff that meat in there.
You're still chomping on that thing, huh?
Keebs.
Yeah?
This is f***ed up.
The boy's not right.
Come on, Bert.
Give it a good Illinois send-off in New Hampshire.
The fire lane is now clear.
Did the can not take it?
It did. It didn't explode, though.
All right, let me see your shooting smells dance. Great, don't
it? All right, well, Al, thank you very much.
Thanks, Al.
And I hope we did it justice for you. We enjoyed that. We've had a birthday, death of a chicken.
Yes.
You know what we need now? All right, this is a very special moment when you come to the Stealth Shack. Lady and gentlemen, what are we going to do?
Spoon.
They brought spoons all the way from Illinois to leave here in the shack, and we are absolutely honored by that. Let's do it. I guess we'll go in order here.
We came, we saw, we spooned.
Make sure it's gonna slide right in there.
So what spoon is that that's bent up? Is there a name on that?
I don't see one on that.
Well, that's beautiful.
There she is.
Perfect.
Make sure it's gonna take a
right.
Nice job.
I'm
gonna shove it way up in there.
Is that
spoon
you have
a
hand?
There we go.
And now, because I'm old and crusty, I think I've brought the crustiest spoon ever. That. Hey, that's a nice fit in there. Awesome. Nice.
Thanks, guys. Remember to
thank
sign
you.
The, sign that and oh, there you so go.
How is it? How's the milk, baby?
Wait, I still don't have it. Keep holding.
I can't wait.
Thank you, baby. Nicely done.
Oh, no. I can't
do
that.
I got you.
No, you're killing my leg, man. I'm old. I'm feeble.
Well, I automatically figured out that that's going to make a great screenshot for caption this. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Charlie.
So what this coin ended up being, it's from Ireland, dated 1769. It's a half penny made of copper, and it has the Irish harp on it, commonly known as the Airy Hibernia. I'm really excited about this. It's a great find.
Well, everybody, it's the end of day 3 and 4. You know what that means? You're gonna have to tune back in next week for part 3 of Stealthstock. You realize this is the first Stealth Diggers trilogy? Whoa. So, I'll give you a little tickle of what's to come next week.
Hey!
How you doing?
Good!
Nice to meet you, Donnie.
Yeah. I actually beat Keebler today. I'm kind of impressed with myself.
Funk 49.
Because
when
it gets your heart going.
It does get your heart going.
Well, this is bad.
I really blew the space-time continuum crystals this time.
And we'll see you there. Till then, stay young. Always keep them guessing. Live free or die. And be good to each other. See ya.
All right, guys. That is what is known as an orbit. We just did about 7 miles around the perimeter. What I'm going to do is I'm going to leave you guys here for about a half an hour. After that, you can start. I want to see if you can find your way back. The sun's setting in this direction, and we've got about 7 miles to go.
Seven miles to go?
Yeah!
The sun sets in the north?
No.
Does it ever end?
North is that way.
Oh!
West
oh.
is this way.
So tired.
Okay.
Anybody got water? I need water!
You should have conserved. All right. So I'll see you guys back at the shack, or do you want me to wait a kid?
Who's going to be piggyback ride?
Bye!
Time continuum work?
North.
This way?
No, this way.
No, it's this way.
Follow the sun this way.
This way? That way.
Wait, that's north, isn't it?
I'm taking a nap, screw this.
I just
got my shirt really dirty, didn't I?
Did I get
the good on my
pin for you?
Wake us up when you get hit here.
Alright
guys,
you
can
go. We're okay. Does it feel like you got one on you?
No.
You want David to come in and check your undercarriage?
Yeah, I'm bent over
because
my clothes now.
Did you hear that?
Yep.
Oh, he's already, he's prepared.
I'm ready.
He's got a flashlight and everything.
Coming in, Canoodles. You're gonna need a magnifying glass. What if I really was naked?
Then Charlie would have it on camera.
Right.
You'd have to do one of those super zoom in shots to see anything anyway.
His undercarriage looks like a mannequin.
A Ken doll?
If I say to you tomorrow,
makes sense.